लोगस्य उज्जोयगरे धम्मतिथयरेजिणे अर्हन्ते कित्तैस्सं चौवीसं पिकेवली।
You just heard few lines of a very popular and ancient Jain prayer called Logas Sutra. It basically glorifies those who have illuminated the world by their preachings. I've shared the link of the entire Logas Sutra in the description below. In this video, I've tried to explain Jainism in a simple way. This video is not only for Jains but also for non-Jains, as I've talked about Jainism as a way of life. The highlight of this video is the talk with my great-grandfather, who would be sharing his insights on Jainism, which could be interesting for everyone. Hello friends, this is Reet. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Have you ever thought why it is important to follow religion? It's important because all religions are a foundation for morals and beliefs. It helps us to shape ourselves and determine what we see as right and wrong. Some of the main religions prevailing in today's world are Hinduism, Buddhism, Christianity, Islam, Sikhism and Jainism. I'm born in a Jain family and I've grown up learning up the beliefs of Jainism from my elders, especially from my great-grandfather. I think you would all agree with me that grandparents can be positive role models and influences, and they can provide us a sense of cultural heritage and family history. I'm blessed to have the guidance of my great-grandfather, who is a lawyer by profession and a Jain philosopher. He has been an inspiration for so many. By his academic and professional excellence, his utmost discipline and spiritual life, and his unparalleled modesty and humility towards all living beings, I'm happy to share that he has entered into his 100th year.
Jai Jinendra. It is a common salutation amongst Jains.
When they meet each other, the real meaning of Jinendra is the lords who have attained moksha.
My great-grandfather. For watching him speaking about Jainism, please watch this full video till the end, as I'm sure you'll find it very interesting. Before that, please subscribe my channel. Jainism is an ancient religion. It is one of the oldest religious traditions of the world. There have been references about Jainism in Rig Veda. In the modern world, it is a small but influential religious group with about 5 million followers. Mostly in India. Outside India, some of the largest Jain communities are in Canada, Europe and United States. It is also growing in Japan, where more than 5,000 ethnic families have adopted Jainism. Jains are divided into two major sects, the Digambars and the Shvetambars. Each of these sects are further divided into subgroups. The core ideologies of Jainism remain same with both the sects, while having some differences between them. Jains do not believe in gods as creators of the other religion. They worship 24 great souls called Tirthankars or food makers. Tirthankars are also called Jana, Arihants or as a victor in Jainism. They are also referred as a savior who were born as human beings, but they have attained a state of perfection and enlightenment through meditation and self-realization. The first Tirthankar, Lord Rishabhdev, was from the Stone Age. Lord Mahavir was the 24th and the last Tirthankar of the Jain religion. He was born in 599 BC. Lord Mahavira propagated Jainism widely. The five goals of Jainism are: Number 1. Non-violence or Ahimsa. The supreme principle of Jain living is non-violence. Lord Mahavira said, all living beings desire to live. He gave a slogan, live and let live. Therefore, we should not harm or kill any living being. Jainism's most important idea is that people should not be violent in what they think, they do and they say. Truth or Satya. Truthfulness is a second principle and it should be adopted in a threefold manner. In thought, in word and in deed. Non-stealing. According to the third vow of non-stealing, a Jain must not take anything that does not belong to him without permission. Celibacy or Brahmacharya. The fourth vow of celibacy is for the monks who follow it strictly. Non-attachment or Aparigraha. And finally, the fifth vow of Aparigraha is the concept of non-possessiveness. It means to limit possession to what is necessary and important. Our desires are unending like the sky. We should limit them. The three guiding principles of Jainism are right belief, right knowledge, and right view. All souls can attain moksha to get free from the cycle of births and deaths by following these principles. Jainism believes purely in the theory of karma. Whatever good or bad happens to an individual is solely on account of his or her past karmas. It is believed every event in life of a man occurs due to the karmas accumulated by him in the previous birth. It is said, as you sow, so shall you reap. Jainism's path of non-violence has influenced world leaders from Mahatma Gandhi to Martin Luther King. In the words of Mahatma Gandhi, no religion of the world has explained the principle of ahimsa so deeply and scientifically as discussed in Jainism. Jains believe that animals and plants as well as human beings contains living souls. Each of these souls are considered of equal value and should be treated with respect and compassion. Lord Mahavira advocated equality for both men and women, rich and poor. Women are given high respect in Jain religion. Jain community is the largest vegetarian community in the world. Jain's meal excludes underground vegetables such as potato, garlic, onion, etc. to prevent harming small insects and microorganisms, also to prevent the entire plant getting uprooted and killed. Jains believe that the last meal of the day should be taken before sunset. Even the doctors and nutritionists suggest the same for good health. Jainism had given utmost importance for protecting ecology and environment. Animals, plants, vegetables and environment are helpful to human beings. All the agencies of nature like rivers, lakes, mountains, etc. must be protected and preserved. This is a Jain emblem which was unanimously chosen in the year 1974 on the auspicious 2500th anniversary of the Nirvana of the last Tirthankar Lord Mahavira. This is also called symbol of Ahimsa, which means non-violence. It has a hand with a Dharma Chakra and a Swastika. Every day Jains bow their heads and say their universal prayer, the Navkar Mantra. All good work and events start with this prayer of salutation and worship. I personally chant this prayer before going to bed, during the exams or at times of anxiety. Believe me, chanting this prayer helps in giving inner strength. There are a number of Jain temples in India and abroad. They are masterpieces of architecture with intricate carvings, beautiful idols and much more. Each of these temples are an oasis of serenity. Some of the famous Jain temples are Ranakpur Jain Temple in Rajasthan, Dilwara Temple in Rajasthan, Shravan Belagoda in Karnataka, Palitana Temples in Gujarat, Kulpakji Temple in Telangana, Shikharji Temple in Jharkhand, Girnarji Temple in Gujarat. Jain monks live a hard life. They don't use any transportation. They walk barefoot, wear only white cotton cloth, eat the food which is donated to them, cover their mouth or nose with a cloth because they prefer to abide non-violence. Now I will be talking about Jain festivals. Pariyushan is the most important annual holy event for Jains, which is usually celebrated in August or September. It lasts for 8 to 10 days. This festival is an important time for Jains during which they often fast and meditate. The festival concludes with people greeting each other with Chami Dukram, seeking forgiveness for any harm or hurt caused intentionally or unintentionally. Mahavir Jayanti is another important festival in Jainism. It celebrates the birth anniversary of the 24th Tirthankar Mahavir, who played a significant role in preaching Jainism. Diwali has a very special significance in Jainism. It marks liberation of Mahavira's soul. Now you'll all get to see my great-grandfather sharing his thoughts on Jainism.
Jainism is one of the oldest religions amongst the world religions. Jainism was not founded by Lord Mahavir or any Lord or any Tirthankara. It has been in existence. According to Jainism, universe has not been founded by any agency. Jainism believes into universal peace and universal coexistence for all living beings. Universe is also, they believe, is not created by anyone. It is self-created by evolution. It is the individual who has to endeavor to take control of his body so as to do away with the past karmas as well as the existed karmas which has spoiled his life and his wisdom. He should see to it that he is not misguided by his desires. He should attain desirelessness And this can only be done when he practices Jainism earnestly. The basic tenets of Jainism are non-violence and superiority of soul over the body. I know it is not easy to follow it completely, but doing little will also make a difference. Jainism can help you to understand your inner self and reach your ultimate goal. Control your anger through forgiveness, arrogance through humility, deception through honesty, greed through contentment. I wish you a very peaceful and happy life.
Nothing can dim the light that shines from within. When you possess light within, you see it externally. So stay hooked, because I'll be uploading more videos on my channel. I hope you have liked this informative video on Jainism. If it has helped you to learn about the same, please like my video and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.